Carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no more.
Alright, so the new card that was added to GTAV Online August 8th was the Bravado Gauntlet Classic, a member of the Muscle Car class. It's definitely nice to see that Rockstar is adding vehicles to other classes of cars other than just that of the Sport and Supercar classes. I feel a lot of past updates tend to focus way too much on those classes and not enough on other classes of cars, however Rockstar seems to be improving this with the past couple of updates. As we've seen with the Arena Wars, but a number of cars that were among other car classes such as Muscle, which included vehicles such as the Shyster Deviant and the Class A Vamos. I always feel the Muscle Car class has been overlooked in a number of updates, so once again, it's nice to see a new addition to this class. So this vehicle appears to be modeled mostly after the 1970s Dodge Challenger, hence the name Bravado Gauntlet Classic. This vehicle has a number of customization options that can be applied. Obviously, it has all the typical options that most, if not all, other GTA 5 Online vehicles have, such as arm upgrades, engine tuning, turbo upgrades, etc. This vehicle also has some pretty cool chassis and hood options, especially if you're trying to make your vehicle look more like a race car. It has some front and rear fender options, which is also pretty cool. I'm not quite sure if a lot of other muscle cars have this customization option, but in any case, it definitely looks sick on this car. It also has some unique roofing customization options that include a vinyl roof, as I stated, really adds to the uniqueness of this car. On the topic of uniqueness, this vehicle has 11 unique liveries that can be applied, as well as trim color, which isn't as unique as the liveries, but always a cool customization option. It also has those cool headlights that have a cover that opens and closes when you turn them on and off, so there's only a handful of vehicles in the game that have this type of headlights, so it's always cool to receive a vehicle that has them likewise. This vehicle is also among only a handful of classic vehicles that are present in the game, such as the Gran Turismo Classic and Pegassi Infernus Classic, which actually happens to be the podium vehicle this week, which is pretty cool. But it's always cool to receive a classic vehicle, no doubt. Rockstar seems to have been adding a few classic rides every update for the past few updates, so hopefully they continue this trend. So I'll let you guys take a look at the rest of the customization options, and then we'll get into the performance of this car.
The cops stop you? Don't tell them I installed that. How many cars you got in this garage again?
Now we did some speed tests with this car against what are considered some of the fastest, if not the fastest muscle cars in the game. As we did with the video of the Vicer Neo, my friend and I swapped vehicles in order to assure the accuracy of our tests and account for any errors such as a broken R2 button. As you'll see, we began by putting the Bravado Gauntlet Classic against the DeClassic Yosemite. You'll see with the first round, the DeClassic Yosemite absolutely blew the Gauntlet Classic away. Pretty much as soon as the race started, the DeClassic Yosemite had the Bravado Gauntlet Classic beat right out of the gate. Now in the second race, it's pretty funny as you'll see. I tried to do the muscle car jump that could be done by all muscle cars in the game, and absolutely screwed it up. It slowed me down quite a bit, but the funny part is, the Class of Yosemite still won. This goes to show just how fast the Class of Yosemite is. So far, the Bravado Gauntlet Classic is 0-1 for wins versus losses. The second vehicle we tested against the Gauntlet Classic was the Vapid Pisswasser Dominator. So for the first test, the Vapid Pisswasser Dominator absolutely dominated the Gauntlet Classic. I mean, no pun intended, but it didn't even stand a chance. As soon as the race started, the Pisswasser Dominator pulled ahead immediately. There was absolutely no competition between these two vehicles at all. As you would have guessed it, the second race was very similar. The Vapid Pisswasser Dominator once again dominated the Gauntlet Classic. So as of now, the Gauntlet Classic is 0-2 for wins versus losses against other muscle cars. The third and final vehicle we tested against the Gauntlet Classic was the Class A Sabre Turbo Custom. Not surprisingly, this vehicle also beat the Gauntlet Classic by quite a bit. Once again, the Gauntlet Classic had really no chance of winning against the Sabre Turbo Custom. Our second test went similar as to be expected. The Gauntlet Classic lost once again to the Sabre Turbo Custom. So our final win-loss record for this vehicle and this video is 0-3. Not that great in performance for the Bravado Gauntlet Classic, specifically speed-wise. So just to wrap up this video, I wanted to do an overall review of this car. Number 1. This car does have some unique customization, like the liveries and vinyl roofing. Number 2. It's a classic car which there aren't a ton of in the game, but they appear to be growing as seen with the past few updates. Number 3. This vehicle does have similar looks to other muscle cars, such as the Classe Vamos and Sabre Turbo Custom, so definitely take that into consideration when considering the uniqueness of this vehicle. Number 4. This car has a price tag of $615,000. Number 5. The car's performance isn't the greatest, as seen with the speed test. Doesn't mean the vehicle handles really bad, but you definitely don't want to be taking this car into a race, that's for sure. Overall, I would give this vehicle a 7 out of 10. Now, as I've stated, it is a classic ride, which I say definitely adds some value to it, especially if you're trying to collect all the classic cars in the game. However, its performance isn't the greatest, so you really would only be buying this car solely for show and enjoyment. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video, as TGKS Productions will be continually uploading content. As always, have a great day.